Hi, I'm Pascal. I'm product manager at Kistler for electronic devices such as charge amplifiers, and I'm dealing with piezoelectric measuring chains every day. From time to time, I get calls from customers saying, I've got a drifting piezoelectric measuring chain. What shall I do? Well, in such situations, two points are crucial to quickly identify the root cause of the drift. Firstly, you must know the potential sources of drift in a piezoelectric measuring chain, and secondly, you need a systematic approach to troubleshooting. So far so good, but what is actually a drift in a piezoelectric measuring chain? A drift is a parasitic current and is expressed in picocoulombs per second. Both negative and positive drifts can occur in a piezoelectric measuring chain. In this video, I'm going to focus on linear drifts only. However, be aware that in piezoelectric measuring chains, also nonlinear drifts can occur, for example, caused by temperature influences on the sensor. Let's have a look at the typical piezoelectric measuring chain. A piezoelectric sensor is connected to a charge amplifier through a high-insulating cable. The charge amplifier converts the charge generated by the sensor into a proportional analog output voltage. Usually, the analog output of the charge amplifier is connected to a data acquisition system through a standard voltage cable to digitize the measurement signal. For further processing and visualization, the acquired measurement signal is transferred to a PC via Ethernet or USB connection. So, what are potential sources of drift in a piezoelectric measuring chain? Since drift is a parasitic current, only components where a charge signal is generated, transferred, or processed can contribute to drift. Specifically, these are the piezoelectric sensor, the high-insulating cable, and the charge amplifier. Let's take a look at the potential sources of drift for each component. For the piezoelectric sensor, the most common source of drift is a contaminated connector, which reduces the insulation. The contamination can be caused by any kind of dust, dirt, or liquids such as oil. For such cases, Kistler offers a special cleaning spray to remove the contamination. To prevent contamination of the connector, it must be protected with the supplied caps when no cable is connected. Another source which could cause drift is a damaged insulation section inside the sensor. Causes for a damage can be a range overload of the sensor, operation of the sensor outside a specified temperature range, or a mechanical stress on the connector. In the last case, the stress can lead to a crack in the weld seam around the connector. Moisture can penetrate the sensor through the crack and reduce the insulation inside the sensor. For the high insulating cable, obviously, connector contamination also leads to drift. A second possible source for drift is a damaged insulation layer. Often, the damage is caused due to excessive bending of the cable or pulling on the cable too strongly, which can lead to tearing off on the connector side. In rare cases, cable chafing of a moving cable on a sharp edge can damage the insulation layer. Also with the charge amplifier, contamination of the connector can lead to drift. An additional source of drift is a defective input stage. In such a case, a leakage current at the charge amplifier input or an insufficient insulation of a charge amplifier circuit component can be the root cause. For charge amplifiers in general, it is very important to stick to the specified temperature and humidity operating ranges. In case a device is operated outside the specified environmental conditions, moisture may condense inside the device and destroy the insulation sections. Since you're familiar with the potential sources of drift in a piezoelectric measuring chain now, I recommend checking the video on troubleshooting and identifying the drifting component. In case you have any questions, feel free to contact us. I hope this video was helpful for you, and I'll catch you in another one.